Thank you. I'm Joanna. Yeah. I work with SCAPE, based at the University of St Andrews, and we champion, we research and we rescue the archaeology of Scotland's coast. Public involvement is at the heart of everything we do, and we've been doing this for, this is our 19th year, so we're quite similar to what Ollie was talking about in Citizen, but we're just a lot older, and yes, as you can see. And this is us, our small team, and I'm speaking on behalf of all of us. There's Ellie and Tom up there. As you can see, there are only three of us. We are a national organisation. So the first point I want to make is that we rely on volunteers. It's not altruism on our part. We need local experience and knowledge. We rely on volunteers to bring sites to our attention, to inspire creative responses to heritage loss, which is what we deal with mostly, and to provide the capacity to get interesting things done. And today I'm using our recent Scotland's Coastal Heritage at Risk project just as an example of how we collaborate very equally actually with volunteers and their impact to the sector, to Scotland's coastal heritage. And to conclude, I'm just going to play you a very short film so you can hear at first hand some feedback from our volunteers about just picking some of the things that they get out of it. So between 2012 and 2016, we worked with many hundreds of volunteers in a national vulnerability assessment of coastal heritage at risk in Scotland. You can download the full report there, the results report. The results are now being used by the sector in Scotland for strategic management, resource allocation, and research priorities. And an exciting outcome of this work was the detection of wider trends of coastal change since 1996 in the aggregated data collected mostly by volunteers. And this opens up the potential of using coastal heritage data in climate change research. So that's where we're going. This is a really important research outcome, and it was enabled by the knowledge and capacity brought to the project by volunteers. We work with heritages that is being lost, but we see this as an opportunity for learning and enjoyment and for benefiting society today. We're not about preservation, we're about opportunity. Each one of these projects on the screen was nominated and brought to us by a volunteer or by a member of the public, and some of them are quite ambitious, and they're all volunteer-led projects. So this has resulted in a great body of case studies of positive responses to loss of heritage, which can be used by others as inspiration. Our network of trained volunteers are embedded in local communities across Scotland, and so this creates a legacy of stewardship for coastal heritage, which is really important for coastal management, sustainable coastal management. And the impact of volunteers is particularly felt in the data collection and the taking action, which drives the heritage management cycle. So to conclude, I would like you to hear for yourself some of the varied impacts expressed by our volunteers as a result of their involvement in coastal heritage at risk in Scotland. And hopefully this will work. That's the video.
Just increased my enthusiasm and passion for archaeology, and I wish I was younger and I would have done it long ago.
Because it's kind of history stuff and it doesn't really impress me, but as I got into it, it was quite fun.
I think it's a big community on board because they're the people who are around to see the changes that occur and can hopefully record what's happening and take photographs and keep an eye on things.
It got me out, really looking at my local coastline, and I really valued that.
It was something, it was quite a good way to learn some skills and techniques. That was one of the cool things that I learned from SCHARP is all the RTI imagery and the photogrammetry techniques which I've used and enjoy using myself. I do it just for fun. These types of projects, they're good ways of getting people interested in the whole field of archaeology, and it's a good way to make new archaeologists, I would say.
It's better than going on holiday.
It's almost boring for others, kind
of. I suppose it's taking on sort of a responsibility for some of the sites up here and getting to know them better too and seeing how they've changed over past few years?
Is as much about serious research, original research, but we love going out as a gang. And that's what this project really offers.
The main thing was, I think, being able to tap into expertise that we would never, ever, ever been able to do. I met people who were exciting and had done things that I learned from them. I also found it really, I suppose, stimulating, because we had this thing in the town and it was something which we as a community could get involved with, but at the same time having the ability to actually spread ourselves and meet other people and just take the message that we thought we were fabulous to everybody else and get the support.
For me, it reinvigorated my desire to get involved in the archaeological world. You know, I've been on a volunteer dig since I got involved in the project, and I've actually been inspired to sign up for a course at the University of Highlands and Islands off the back of getting back involved in archaeology.
I met some wonderful people at all these various conferences and things. Especially our conference up in St Andrews was tremendous. You know, I thought I'd pass on doing all sorts of things, but I've actually found a new lease of life with this project, and I think that's been very useful as you get old. It's rather nice to be involved in something else.